The problem of losing parameter bindings is pretty widespread, since any function like setTimeout that takes another function as a callback may actually call that function differently than you expected. Callback functions are inherently designed so that they will be invoked by the system you pass them to. Thus, you generally have very little control over what the bindings will be for the parameters of the functions that you passed in. For this reason, you need to be careful about all the parameter bindings, including the parameter this, whenever you pass a function as an input to another function, despite the fact that you see an object on the left of the dot when you pass the function in. This object will not be passed along as the binding for the parameter this, when the system you passed it to eventually calls your callback function. One way to pass a callback without complicating the parameter binding situation is to pass a different function, one that doesn't receive any parameters at all, including this. Then, you just make room in the body of that function for your custom code, and inside that area, you reference your method, and then you can do the invocation yourself, passing along whichever bindings you want for the parameter this. We've talked a lot about the keyword this, where it appears within a function, and some value may have been passed in to be bound to it. But what would happen if we saw the keyword this appearing in the global scope, not inside the body of any functions at all? Taking a step back for a moment, we should first consider what we expect to happen when we access parameters outside of the function scope that they were defined within. What would we expect to happen with this attempt to log the one variable?